Thanks, Philip. Yeah, as Philip said, I've been talking about food waste for years now, sometimes talking to myself, but all of a sudden I find a lot of people are listening and a lot of people are really interested. Every time you talk to people, they're like, oh yeah, food waste, very important issue, someone needs to do something about it. And in general, it's someone else who needs to do something about it, but the fact is that we all waste food, every single one of us. I waste food, even though I've been talking about it for an awful long time. More often than not, people point at, you know, oh, the retailers, the supermarkets, they waste an awful lot of food, they need to do something. So do the producers. I've gone on too far here. This is actually the figures we have here, that food waste is wasted all along the food chain and pretty much evenly all along. So not one single sector is responsible for food waste. 1 million tons is the amount of food that we waste in Ireland every year. I would imagine nobody's ever actually seen what a ton of food waste looked like, so I thought I'd put up a picture. Because the thing about food waste is we put it in our kitchen caddy, we might bring it out to the bin, and then someone takes it away. So we don't really worry about it too much. That's kind of, it's someone else's problem at that stage. So the environmental impact of food waste. I suppose it's one of the things I'm different here today. As Philip mentioned, nobody really thinks about the environment when they're buying food. There's probably a few of you in the room here today. There's quite a, you know, let's call it select few people who do think about the environment. But general people, they go into the supermarket, they want to, as people have said earlier on, I don't know why this is moving on. They want to get in, they want, you know, there's convenience, there's nutrition, there's something that everyone in the household will eat, all of that thing, that stuff. But actually, this is an interesting statistic from the Food and Agricultural Organization, that if food waste was a country, it would be the third biggest generator of greenhouse gases after the USA and China. So the problem of food waste is quite a significant problem. It uses food that is not consumed, not just food that's produced, but not consumed, uses around 200 times the land mass of Ireland globally, and about 100 times the volume of water in the River Shannon. So I suppose my point here is that there's an awful lot of resources that goes into producing food. Not only are there the water, the energy, you have the farmer's time, you know, you have fertilizer input being transported, then it's transported to whoever, you know, the wholesaler, to the retailer, and then finally to us, the consumer. We take it home, we put it in our fridge. More often than not, then we probably just throw it in the bin. And then it ends up producing greenhouse gases when it's decomposing as well. More often than not, all of those resources, the further down the supply chain you are, the more input has been there. So in fact, food waste from the consumer level, that is actually more important than food waste higher up the supply chain. I thought I'd throw this in because packaging is really it's being debated at the moment, this whole idea, all plastic is wrong, we need to stop it, we need to prevent it. I put in, obviously, ridiculous packaging. This is bananas that have been peeled and packaged, and we have oranges that have been peeled and put into lovely little plastic cups. Obviously, those kind of things we don't need, but say, what about a milk bottle? There's a new kind of upswell of people wanting glass milk bottles. They think plastic and Tetra Pak are harmful to the environment. The thing about a glass bottle is it's much heavier, so to transport it, it uses an awful lot more greenhouse gases. So it's not always the right choice. And I put up the shrink-wrapped cucumbers because I get asked about these all the time. So why put plastic on a cucumber? But that shrink wrap actually increases the shelf life of a cucumber 3 times, so it actually prevents it from being wasted. There's also innovation in packaging. There's an awful lot of development at the moment in terms of what's called intelligent food packaging. This is one where we have a little dot that appears on it, and once the package is opened, as the atmosphere inside the ham starts to change, it changes colour. Now, it doesn't replace a use-by date, which is there for safety reasons, but it does give the homeowner an idea of, well, that's been open quite a while in the fridge, need to think about using it. This is an example of plastic films that have been created that keep fruit and veg fresher for longer. So, and we see some of these in our supermarket shelves at the moment. So I suppose my point here is that packaging has a role to play in food waste. And if you look at the environmental impact of food waste versus plastic packaging, food waste is worse. There have been a few studies done on this. There's been a study done on the actual life cycle analysis of plastic packaging. Once it's recycled, it's better. So I think there is a lesson there in terms of not all plastic packaging is recyclable, and this is the kind of message we need to focus on. So rather than beating yourself up in the supermarket going, God, I really don't want to be buying plastic, the message is more, I want to buy plastic that is recyclable, and if it'll help me keep my food fresher for longer. This is the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. Ireland signed up to these along with 200 other countries in the world in 2015. One of those goals is the Sustainable Development Goal 12.3. And the goal there is by 2030, we will have halved the global food waste in the retail and consumer level, because they are the most important when it comes to environmental impact, and then also reduce food losses along production and supply chains, including post-harvest losses. So Ireland signed up to this. What have we been doing about it? Well, in fact, quite a lot. Yet again, behind the scenes, it's a subject that a lot of people talk about, but they don't like to talk about it publicly. So we've done some work with the main supermarkets in Ireland, the main retailers, and they've been quite open, and it's actually been really interesting working with them, because more often than not you do hear, oh, the supermarkets create all this waste and, you know, they need to stop, they're pushing food on us that we don't need to buy. But actually when you do talk to them, you understand real problems that they have in dealing with this. They need to deal with consumer choice. People want choices. We've just spoken about that this morning. People also want to see full shelves. People don't want to buy the last loaf of bread. People don't want to buy the last lonely tomato in a box. So stuff that we do does actually generate food waste further up the supply chain. And more often than not, these are things that maybe we don't consciously do them. There's a lot of subliminal things, but it's things that we do need to think a little bit more about in terms of if we want to have strawberries at Christmas time. By doing that, you have to acknowledge that somewhere along the supply chain, food waste has been created. So I think, you know, more often than not, pointing to other people and saying they need to do something about it, we need to reflect a little bit more on what our choices do and how our choices can impact on how the retailers react to what we choose. Now, I suppose finally, just the question was, how can we buy better? In fact, Connor covered a lot of them. Most of his tips are also tips to reduce food waste. If you try and eat healthily, learn to cook, and say, but the really tough one is buy what you need and use it on time. And that's shopping lists. That's where the shopping list comes in there. And then the other thing, I suppose I just pointed out, we have our website is stopfoodwaste.ie, and there we have a lot of information on what consumers can do to reduce food waste. And we've just recently developed this new section of it, which will become an app eventually, as called the A to Z of food. So basically, most of those fresh fruit, vegetables, bread, dairy, things that you're not quite sure, how do you keep them fresher for longer? How can you freeze them? How long do they keep in the freezer? We have kind of information there, and the idea of that is just to help consumers make a bit more informed choices when they've got the stuff home and how they can keep it fresher for longer. Packaging, like I said, the jury's still out. Avoid unnecessary packaging is what we're talking about. So don't buy peeled bananas. Thankfully, I've never seen them in Ireland, but or peeled oranges. I think I have seen those, unfortunately. And then, as Connor mentioned as well, like buy more local seasonal food. And that doesn't necessarily mean going to your farmer's market, because a lot of the main retailers now are focusing on producing, on supplying local food. I would generally look at the country of origin when I am buying fruit and veg. I notice some of the German retailers are now producing kind of organic, locally grown food, which is even better and not too expensive either, you know. So I suppose that kind of thing is buy it, vote with your pocket, so that send the message back. I'm delighted to see this stuff in the supermarket. It might cost a little bit more, and that is one of the key things here, that the cost of food is generally, and it's a bit controversial, but it's too cheap, because that's why we throw it away. We don't appreciate the value of it. The environmental costs, and even a lot of the time, the I suppose, the cost to produce the food have been externalized and they're not reflected in the price of what we buy. And maybe that might see more expensive food, but it would certainly mean we'd be less likely to be throwing it away. I just threw in the Best in Season website there. That's by Bord Bia, and I just thought it's one of the better ones. I suppose it's in an Irish context in terms of what's in season and that, so it's somewhere to start with. And then I have this video here, which I think just sums up. It's the journey of a strawberry, and the idea is just to kind of show the resources that have gone into it and eventually what happens to it. Thank you.